Hello, what is? My name is Animeka Drawer. Welcome back to Fields of Justice. Trial Tribulations. We are at the office. Yep. You know, I glad we found the urnal, but poor Mr. Light got arrested again.
Well, supposedly Mr. Light was in the CEO's office where the murder occurred.
No way, Yost! No way, Yost! I don't buy it! But I wonder who the busy light was there. It was just like himself, at least, from what I can hear you said. Looks like you did a good job of a job this time, Mr. Nick.
How about we get started looking into those KB securities better?
I think I'm going to head back to Kuri Village for a while, little while, if it's alright.
Sure, but why?
I'm going to bring the second room back and have some people take a look at it. Oh, that's a good idea. I think we could put... No, Mr. Gray, you stay here. I wanted you to spend some special quality time together, full of love and happiness.
Maybe first she's so caught up in her fantasy she forgot to submerge herself.
Now remember, no fight, okay?
She's gone.
Okay, Nick, time to get some... Going to... On this murder investigation!
Sorry, it was a fly here.
Hold on, there's not me!
As that beautiful voice not to persist to silence.
So they're interrogating Mr. Delight right now.
Man, we don't have enough time as it is.
Yeah, well, I guess the police are crazy, going crazy like we are. Yesterday they thought he was a thief, and now they got a murder case on their head.
I guess you're right. The car over there looks a bit edged too.
Come on, we have to come back later.
Okay, let's go check it out, okay? Nick!
Oh my god.
Oh, Nicky boy, who are you?
Mr. Light.
All I wanted to do was help my dear Ronnie.
Yeah, but I guess it didn't look hurt in his case.
Don't say that, Nick. She doesn't need your help beating yourself up.
Hey, Nicky boy, please help Ronnie.
It's not a killer, I swear. My Ronnie wouldn't hurt a fly. Or the poker, every poker around and see what I can find out.
Really? Are you serious?
Oh, I'm so happy.
And you asking for your help was the right thing to do.
I don't know what I can do to help anymore. I have no idea Mr. Light was such a vulnerable side.
Listen carefully, Nicky boy. My Ronnie would never ever kill anyone. It's just not him.
I don't think he would, dear Nick.
Yeah, but you have to admit he's got a bit of a temper to him.
That's not...
It's not that hard to imagine him snapping and screaming, please die.
He would never say that. Anyway, Mr. Light, he might not be a killer, but he's still going around saying that he's a thief.
I already told you, that's just a fantasy for him.
Mr. Light, I hate to say it, but you're the one living in a fantasy world.
But what? How dare you say that to me, Nicky boy? I know everything about my Ronnie. We don't have any secrets between us. Ronnie's the thief type. He's honest that he wouldn't even sneak a nap. He's honest that he wouldn't even steal his glance. Thief? Ha! The very day,
I guess I just don't get it.
Huh? What?
I just can't understand how they can be so different and yet be so a couple.
Yeah, they sure are different. Come on, Nicky boy. It's not that mysterious, is it? It was a love at first sight, for me anyway.
What? For you?
I don't know, but...
So was it really love at first sight when you first met Mr. Light?
Well, maybe not first sight, but Ronnie saved my life.
Save your life?
I was at work one day when two robbers suddenly rushed in. Well, another kind of... They just curled a little ball in the corner, so I fell back.
Robbers?
Yes, they took me hostage. I was so frightened. They were both carrying just huge knives, and I broke down their ears.
Yeah, I would too if I were in the situation.
Oh, I think I get it. Did Mrs. Light come ready to say you? Yes, exactly. I remember he looked so handsome in the guardian uniform of this. He went right up to this knife with the robbers and screamed in the faces. Please stop it! He screamed. I couldn't see the robber's face. I could see the robber's face turn pale.
That high-pitched scream of his does not surprise the strong effect of people.
They're crying and swinging his arm just crazy. He attacked the robbers. All by himself, he came to see me. I took the stretcher all by myself. He was so scared that he was crying and shaking, but he still risked his life for me. Wow, that's a great story! Yeah, maybe not look like it, but in some situation, there's no more better. That's why I fell in love with him and like a dad.
That's so romantic, and they fall in love too, I guess.
Nick, I hope you will do it safe for me if I get to take a hostage.
I've been already taken hostage. In landscape. But why are that possibility always seems to loom in the not so distant future?
Mr. Light, do you know anything about cable security? Don't be silly, of course I do. That's where my Robin works.
So she thinks he still works to her? Oh, that's right. I'm going to want to be here today. Oh my god, I forgot this voice. Oh, come on, don't tell me you didn't know it. Ronnie Lightwolf was also deployed as a cable security. He was a professional security guard. But he quit. It doesn't work there anymore.
It looks like Mr. Light doesn't know. Cable security is only about 20 minutes away by motorcycle, that is.
Larry told me it takes 30 minutes per car.
Well, I had to admit that I tend to fly pretty fast on the bike.
To make it to cable security that fast, are you sure you're literally flying?
Why don't we give you a try sometime? Or better yet, how about now?
No way about it, thanks. Why don't you just tell us where it is and where we go ourselves?
What's scaring at you, Nick?
Mr. Light told us the location of the cable security.
Okay, let's head over there. Right away, Nick.
Forget about that, me. Oh my god, did they got stuck in a safe or something? Because I see the marks, the white tapes around the dead body and all that, you know. So I guess this is where it all went down, huh?
There was in here, look, take...
Sorry.
Just like you didn't expect to see us at first.
What has that got to do with anything? Oh hey, it's you guys! Oh, it's Detective Gumshoe. Today was a real train wreck for you guys, huh?
Sure was, pal. The prosecutor made a real fools of us. Out of us.
Yeah, I feel sorry for you. I feel for you.
Wow, that's not like you at all. I thought you'd be like more like... Oh, that was great! You got what you deserved, pal! Something like that.
Do I really sound like that to you, pal?
If the country fits?
Well, anyway. The point is, I can tell when someone puts their heart into the ops. I can tell. And I can sympathize with when things don't go your way. Sometimes I feel like wrong is the only way things go for us detectives.
Well, we had no idea that the coach was such a nice guy.
He always been a nice guy. Now with this, now if this little love fest is over, maybe we can start investigating.
Detective, tell us what you know about the murder.
But the thing is, I'm really not supposed to.
Hey, come on, I want to know about how he put our hearts into our work. things are really working against us right now, and we need help.
Okay, I will tell you. Just don't stop crying on me, okay, pal?
Okay, I won't cry on you, pal.
The victim's name is...
Oh my god, my throat.
The victim's name is Gabe Bullard. He was the CEO of the cable security and a pretty big fella in this, all right. His corpse was discovered at 9 o'clock in this morning. His estimated time of death was 1 o'clock in the morning on October 12th. Cause of death was blood force thrown onto the head, probably an object in this room. It happened exactly the same time the mess was still in the urn, huh?
So why did it take almost an entire day to discover the body?
There's a good explanation for that one. Bullard's body was stashed away inside the safe.
Safe?
Well, it is pretty big. Nobody had to hear from him, and when they opened the safe this morning, out he came.
So the body fell out. I think white string must be the safe from when he fell out.
I think we still need some more information about Mr. Bullard. Billard.
Maybe you can start by getting the man's name right. Billiard.
So, what happened to Mask?
He's at the detention center screaming like a madman. Investigate me again! He keeps yelling.
Oh, no, I didn't mean him. He's not a real thief anyway, right?
Oh, you mean that detective at me? Oh, that was great! The guy got what he deserved!
Now that's the detective I know and love.
Think about it. Admin was always around when the guard showed up. But it was mysterious disappeared when the heist took place. I was hiding at the crime scene. Heh, right. That's the lamest thing I ever heard. That's how you knew he was a thief.
That will explain how he was able to retrieve the stolen item he keeps bragging about.
Yeah, he just did that to make himself look like a great detective, that's all. But there's one thing he can figure out about his first heist.
His first heist?
Yeah, the Tear of Ammonon case. There was a witness on that one.
A witness?
Here is the newspaper clipping. Since the TV is already under arrest, you guys can keep it.
He knows.
Hey, this guard here! Have you seen him before?
His bitch is small, so it's kind of hard to see, but now that you mentioned it. Oh, it's Dr. Miss Ron.
Oh, that prosecutor! I really don't like that guy! The way he used our own evidence to do that to Mr. Delight!
Yeah, I think he did that to just... That way just because he knew it did hurt more. That's why my gut tells me why. Anyway, that's what my guts tell me anyway.
So who is this Java addictive mask maniac anyway?
Prosecutor Gordon? It's got an enigma on her. The thing is, pal, I never heard of that guy before. I just showed up one day at the prosecutor's office. Came out of nowhere.
That's right, he said this was his first case as a prosecutor.
And it's true, according to the records anyway. But, no way he's an amateur. He's on ice with the court and a maverick that gives me goosebumps.
Goosebumps? You?
Yeah, news of it was off about him, so I asked around. Nobody would talk to me. They all just turned the other way.
Oh, poor him.
Poor did he think I'm sure he knew that he was a pup there.
Oh no, that's not what I meant.
That Goro guy sure likes... I get the feeling he's hiding some kind of a dark secret. I didn't see the dialogue.
Did he catch you? Tell us more about Mr. Shandy Bluebird!
That That's Kepler, not Shane Bluebird. Bow.
Oh yeah, the victim in this case doesn't just doesn't make much of an impression on me.
Well, you weren't the victim of it, Mr. Bullard was found dead. Yeah, and his body wasn't discovered until this morning. Anyway, we don't have enough information yet. Can you help us out? Sorry, I'm actually a little confused myself. For some reason, I'm just blabbing like an idiot right now.
Okay, Nick. Now is our chance to get more info about him. About the victim. So hurry up and ask.
Can you tell us some more about Mr. Bullard?
He was the CEO of Gaming Security, right? What kind of a company is it, anyway?
Well, the company basically sends security teams out to guard them. Mr. Bullard must have had a chance to learn a lot of secrets doing this kind of work. Oh, and I don't know how to put this, but the guy was kind of a money grubber.
Really? Me too? I just love money. I can't even get enough.
Please stop leaning towards me like that. You aren't getting to my wallet. She was trying to...
Nick, give me money, please.
Anyway, it looks like he did some pretty shifty stuff to earn his billions.
Oh, so that's my problem. I think I need to be a shifter. Shiftier.
Let me go already. Apparently, he was involved in selling trade card secrets between rival companies. He's like red white stealing information.
Oh, that's pretty dirty, not it?
Yeah. Oh, Gaming Security used to had security operations against Master Mask.
What, really?
Yeah, and after screwing up so many times, the company's reputation really took a nosedive. So it really was Bullard. Thanks, Maya. Who sent her on the Blackbird letter, huh? About this blackmail letter? Yeah, I've been thinking a lot about it too, pal. Why would Kim Bullard have been blackmailing around the light anyway? Well, Mr. Light used to work at the Kiwi Security, right? So what was it made to... what is that made him quit?
Nick, that's it! Maybe this is the reason he's being blackmailed.
Well, I'm in the middle of investigating that right now.
Oh, alright.
This document really looks really important. Check out this big thick binder binder.
Leave the heavy lifting to me, Nick.
Reading a file isn't exactly backbreaking work. Just a little heart on my eyes.
Ah! What did you find, Nick?
This file is not about the social security operations or anything. The usual is all about the master mask. It's filled with the info on him.
What? What kind of info?
It's pretty critical detailed information about his methods of the crime scene.
Hey Nick, look at the last page.
It's a list. Let's see, to a tier of $100,000. It looks like a list of all the treasures Master stole.
So then $100,000 is the value of the stolen item?
I don't know, that number sounds kind of low to me. I think I better secretly make a copy of this list.
There's a button there. Let's see.
Maya, you should click on buttons. Hey, go out. Don't press that.
That was pretty funny. I never knew that a girl could jump like that.
What is that button anyway? It's an emergency buzzer. It says it right there on the panel. Are you blind or something?
Oops, you're right. It's written right there. Nick, how many times have I told you to read the instructions first?
This alarm connects to the basement guard room. It's used to some security up here. Really? Then it's possible on the night of crime?
Oh, so when the CEO was attacked, do you think that maybe he pressed the buzzer?
Yeah, I thought about it too, so I asked around up there. But Chris said that the buzzer never went off that night. Also, we couldn't find any fingerprints on the buzzer. Mr. Bullard, the victim, wasn't wearing the gloves, by the way, so you know. I think we better go and talk to the guard about this emergency buzzer. Looks like some kind of chef running cabinet type hybrid.
I can't get in between those two chefs.
Don't stray yourself too high, it looks like a chef are controlled by a special panel.
So I guess it's one chef at a time, huh? Looks like they're filled with a bunch of files.
Yeah, files with data, files filled with data about security jobs they were hired to handle.
It'd be good, nice reading if you got insomnia. I was hoping for something like a little bit more setting. Like, you have something.
Yep. I recognize the jacket. Larry! Wow, this is really something else.
The security guard office is so very feel. It sure doesn't feel very secure.
Cabin security guard? Uh-oh, I just remember. Larry must be. Hey Nick, what's up? And the music in the background. Oh, so he is here.
Yo, how's the hanging, dude? And you got my sweet little Maya with you, huh?
Hey Larry.
Anyone's working my fingers to the bone. And in works on next year, I got the problems with that day time date. It's all good.
No, that's not what you're here for. We're investigating Buller murder case.
Oh yeah, that's right. You're a lawyer, aren't you?
He's a hopelessly clueless.
Well, if it's about the murdered boy, have I got some good info for you?
Really? What is it?
Well, I don't mind sharing with my sweet little Maya. But Nick, here's a different story.
But Larry, I thought you two were old school buddies.
It was then, and this is now.
So what's this good info you were talking about, Larry?
Hey, you have a bro! I can give you my information for free!
What was to be a bribe? Was a bribe? I thought professionals were more, I don't know, honest? Can I talk to Maya?
Larry, tell us already! What is the good info?
Hey, like that! This kid has got a class! Okay, you really want to know?
Yes! So tell me!
So the thing is that Roddy Light was on a boy here. And now he says that the pro had looked into his background, follow me?
Yes, you're pro. I follow you. Go on.
Well, 1 year ago, Roddy Light was fired. And there was no warning at all. It just happened all of a sudden. I noticed there was more company, but I think that was pretty awful.
I guess he must have done something bad to have got fired like that.
Like maybe skipping out of work to pick on hot chicks or something?
No, that's just you. So what is it like to be a part-time security guard?
Let me tell you, it's tough! Well, you know me, I get by alright, I guess. First, I have to keep my eye on the monitors all the time.
Monitors?
The security cameras in... that an issue in the building? It's really hard, so I feel like my eyes are gonna fall out.
Ow!
And if this is something suspicious, I have to contact one of the teams.
What teams?
The security teams for this company. They are supposed to be the best in business. But I know my engineer, so if it's of a spoiler, I don't bother calling them.
So in other words, you're basically watching TV screens all day. You went to the office when the murder took place, weren't you?
Why do you say that? This is a part of job for me. I can't do pretty much equipment at a dump.
And if it's a part-time, and you're dumb, you're still in charge of security here.
Hey, give me a break. I don't try to pin the whole thing on me. That's not fair, Nick.
Huh?
I don't think you can expect someone like him to take any responsibility.
Anyway, the point is that you were here that night, right, you?
God, Larry. Oh no, I knew his office smelled bad. But
And it was the best. It was the best after all.
Well, it's like I always say. It wasn't then. It was then. This is now. Okay.
It looks like I'm going to have to break the cycle after all.
Hey Larry, there's something I wanted you to look at.
Hey Nick, I told you I'm a pro, and you don't interrupt. And you don't report when I'm smoking. I don't have time to sit chat with you, okay?
Oh, is that right?
Oh, hey, not sure I got time for you, told Maya.
Well, I got time to squeeze this guy if you want. If you want to get the info out of him.
What about this person?
Sorry, pal. To be honest, my head is full of right. It's a fool right now. It feels like it will burst. Not know yourself. Keep hair away from Gojo's head. Wait a minute. Sorry, it's hard to believe, but there's a limit to how much my brain can hold. I got to use the two eyes, but I only got one brain. I can see your eyes and ears. But the jury is still out on a brain thing.
Hey Nick, if you have something to say, just come on to say it.
I know I look a little rough around the edges, but the truth is I'm a lot more detective-like than I used to be.
Really? Like what part?
Like the color of my coat.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah, but what about what's inside the coat? I kind of feel sorry for him. He's kind of sad. He's kind of a sad young man. Guy. Yeah, and he seems to have a habit of always getting arrested prematurely. Well, it's just my personal opinion, but I think the police should have investigated the whole thing more carefully.
But weren't you the one that's arrested with a giant goofy smile on your face?
Come on, we don't have to time to start with that. just leave it alone.
The treasure of Courier and Expert is all ruined now.
Maya,
I'm sorry, you're so sad. It also would be so very much to learn about the spirit channeling.
Maybe because she ripped somehow. Well, now we've got the circuit on back, maybe we can reopen it.
Really?
Sure, we can relabel it the Urn of the Master's Desires. Then we'll be able to attract a lot of attention.
Wow! Wow, wow, wow! That's brilliant, Nick! We could clean up and be filthy rich!
Wow, that was surprisingly easy.
Oh, it's you, Miss Wright.
Miss Andrews, what is she still hanging around here for?
Oh, so how's it going? What about the second urn?
You'll be taken care of already.
What do you mean, not that?
Taken care of?
You mean it's been found? Yes, it was spotted during the trial today.
Wow, really? You really are the greatest, Mr. Wright.
Mr. Wright had nothing to do with it. It was Messy Mask. Mask's wife that found it.
Well, anyway, I'm so relieved.
I thought the whole exhibit would be bright enough for something like shining gold, so that's why I went to trouble borrowing it from the Brad family train hall. Because it is totally cool in my back. It was rather late, so I thought they wouldn't be able to put it display. By the way, it was just that it was put on the theft. Do you know anything about that? Huh? No, it certainly was me that moved it! Why is it so frustrated all of a sudden? I'm sorry, I can't help anymore. Have more, but they're so busy taking over everything from me. I still haven't given up the treasures of current expert. Oh, Miss Sanders, I'm so happy to hear you say that! Looks like the treasure expert is the only thing she has on her mind. That you got the circuit back. Yes, but there's still something that bores me. What is it? I'm not exactly sure. But some of the urn that came back to see different. Really? You wouldn't know anything about that, would you, Miss Andrews? No, I don't know anything. Why would I? She knows something? A cyclock. What do you think this means, Nick? What do you think this means, Nick? This the person holds the secret of the mystery for the secret turn. It's our own very own Miss Andrews. Sanders, do you know anything about the secret room? Do you know anything? I'm sure of that the treasures exhibit. The urn was submitted before the court today. It's obviously not the same urn as before.
What? Well, that's untrue. Maybe it wasn't the same. It could be fake.
A fake?
You're the one who said it wasn't the same, so that's almost a misinformation. Do you have any evidence that the urn that was submitted at the trial was genuine?
Take that! I just thought of the ship because you polished it. Well, Miss Andrews, see, look, it was a fake after all.
Huh? I mean, your evidence is fake too, as expected. Oops, I guess this isn't going to help me much.
So you have queens, do you have? Or do you have any evidence that the Earl was submitted to the court in? I know it is genuine, but because the urn was full of painting. But the painting is there, and on the floor, obviously. Okay, guess that's the end of this episode. We're going to investigate more in next, so thank you for watching, leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you liked it, and thank you for support, and hope to see you in the next episode. Bye bye.